Lots of great things for science observing. Butterfly eggs and caterpillars crawling. Milkweed and parsley, fennel and dill. These are a few of my favorite plants.
Guess who's coming to see ya? Oh yeah, guess who's coming to play? Guess who's got all the creatures for ya? I know who you'll say.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Bug Day 2020 at the Ware Nature Center. I'm Antonio Gustine, the Bug Whisperer, and I am thrilled to be back here again with all of you. Now, some of you may know me from Bug Days of Past, from my live show, Tony's Creepy Crawly Zoo. Now, I don't know what all of you have been up to since I last saw you, but I wrote a book called My Science Diary. My Science Diary is an activity book that is perfect for days like today. It is a book designed to take natural exploring when you're out looking for bugs, frogs, snakes, lizards, whatever, and turn those adventures into critical thinking skills and scientific literacy. Now you can find My Science Diary on Amazon, or you can purchase it at American Science and Surplus here in Milwaukee. Now to go along with this book, we created a new series on my YouTube channel, iBUGWHISPERER. The series goes along with the book and you can watch it, well, today if you wanted to. And be sure to subscribe because we have a whole bunch of new videos coming out. Now, as you heard earlier with my beautiful singing voice, I love plants. Now, I love insects, but if you love insects, it is imperative to know about the relationship that insects have with certain plants. Because if you are out looking for a specific insect, it might be easier to find if you know what plant you can find it on. Now, there are many, many plants that we could learn about, but today I'm just going to tell you about a few, and hopefully these will help you in your own bug day adventures here at the Ware. Now, the first ones I want to tell you about are ones that you may have planted in your own garden. Some of my favorites are parsley, fennel, and dill. These plants are host to one of my favorite butterflies in the entire world, the black swallowtail, otherwise known as Papilio polyzenus asterius.
Now, every year in my own garden, I plant a patch of parsley, fennel, and dill. Just for this reason, I want to see black swallowtail caterpillars. Now, when I filmed this, I got really lucky, and a female black swallowtail came in looking for a place to lay her eggs. Now, wait for it, and there it is. She just laid an egg, and this, my friends, is the egg of a black swallowtail on my dill plant. Now, within a few days, you will start to notice these tiny little pieces of bird poop on your dill plant, but they're not bird poop. They are black swallowtail caterpillars. Now they grow quickly, and within just a few days, they will start to show these colors of green, yellow, black, and white, and they're absolutely stunning. Now this caterpillar is not entirely defenseless. When they are disturbed, they pop these little orange glands off the top of their head that look like horns and emit a noxious little chemical, and your fingers are going to stink. Now if you want, you can always take this caterpillar home and raise it for yourself. Watching the metamorphosis process is one of the most amazing things that you can see. I've seen it hundreds of times, and it just never gets old for me. After pupating, within about 2 weeks, the black swallowtail will emerge, and we're going to be right back here again. I like the black swallowtail caterpillar so much that I even put it on some of our merchandise, which is available at creepycrawlyzoo.com, in case you are interested.
Now, if you are on a bug adventure out at the Ware Nature Center or any other prairie area, what plants should you be looking for? Let's make that easy, shall we? Now, one of the most popular and easily identifiable plants that you will come across
is my friend, the milkweed. Say hi, milkweed. Also known as Asclepias. Asclepias? Asclepias? Asclepias. Asclepias.
Now, the most identifiable type of milkweed is probably the broadleaf milkweed, which you see here with me today. Guys, do you mind? Now, the most famous inhabitant of the milkweed plant is probably the monarch butterfly. And no matter how many times you find one of these caterpillars, it is always, always a thrill. Now you can find monarchs all summer long flying around milkweed plants and laying eggs. And if you look carefully on the underside of the leaves, you can find those eggs yourself. And what can I say? The monarch caterpillar is always stunning. Now milkweed itself is a host to a number of different creatures for different reasons. Now let me show you what I found in this little area alone in under 15 minutes.
Now, milkweed is a plant that can be found in any prairie area in the United States and roadsides. We found a scorpion fly, some cool orange aphids. Very cool. Now, what we've got here are the tussock moth caterpillars. These guys are much more devastating to the milkweed than the monarch caterpillar is, and they turn into these cool orange mohawks. Then we have the milkweed beetle, grasshoppers. Even a cicada was hanging out on a milkweed. Hope he's not drinking that sap. Now this doesn't belong here. This is a tortoiseshell caterpillar, which is extremely cool, but they don't feed on milkweed, and somehow it just found its way. We have a katydid, an assassin bug nymph, a milkweed bug. There was a round-shouldered orb weaver, and even a tree frog was hanging out. My favorite find of the day, though, had to be the spiders in the genus Argiope, commonly known as the yellow garden spider, corn spider, and a few other local monikers. These spiders make an enormous web that is commonly recognized by the zigzag pattern through it, and a lot of times they terrify people, but their venom is harmless to humans. Now, when it comes to insects, we often think of spiders as the ultimate apex predator. But one day you're the predator, the next day you're the prey. This next piece of video was captured by my friend Brandon Porter while we were out filming. And this is a once-in-a-lifetime thing to witness. This is a hornet who went on a seemingly suicidal mission straight into the web of the Argiope to prey upon it. And won.
Now, other great plants that you can find commonly are Queen Anne's lace, prickly ash, and goldenrod at this time of year.
You can find goldenrod in the same places you can find milkweed. Would you like to guess which one of these plants is the goldenrod? Goldenrod is a late summer bloomer that produces cluster flowers that are an extremely important food source to insects that are looking to either hibernate or migrate through the winter. Probably the most dominant insect you will find is this goldenrod soldier beetle. However, you will find everything around goldenrod. Every type of bee you can think of, predators, caterpillars, it's just a fantastic place in late summer to mid-fall to look for insects. Another great plant that you can find throughout the year is Queen Anne's lace. They are easily identifiable by this cluster flower they produce at the top that can be seen all around prairies. In just a quick look, we found some ambush bugs that appeared to be making more ambush bugs. There was a crab spider hanging out underneath, waiting for an unsuspecting butterfly to come by. Even an argiope was using the stem to secure its web. We happened to find a mantis fly. And Queen Anne's lace just happens to be another food source for the black swallowtail caterpillar.
All right, now for this next plant and hunt, I had to put my glasses on because I ain't as young as I used to be. But this plant, we often hate. This is prickly ash, and it's prickly. It hurts. It's got thorns on it that looks like a rose, but you'll often find it on the fringes of forests. But let me show you the treasures that it holds, and you'll see why I needed my glasses on. Now, what you want to look for on a prickly ash is bird poop.
Oh, there it is. I see one. Look.
Do you see it? Do you see the bird poop?
Right there. But it's not bird poop.
This is the caterpillar of the giant swallowtail. And just like the black swallowtail, it has a gland that pops out and makes your fingers stink. It is also another great caterpillar to take home, raise up, watch it pupate, and 10 to 20 days later, bam, largest butterfly in North America.
Now, I hope this video gives you a great start on your own Bug Day adventures at the Weir. And remember that you can always enhance your experience with our new book, My Science Diary, available on Amazon. Now, be sure to subscribe to our newsletter. Again, the link is down below in the description, and you will learn all about the new project we have going on of our permanent location of Tony's Creepy Crawly Zoo, an insect-themed science park. And stay tuned for a live Q&A with me here at Bug Day at the Ware Nature Center 2020.